Ramsey also on this side. So today hand we are dealing with a topic called as quantitative genetics. Okay, so let's get started. Now, starting with the first thing first, the definition of quantitative genetics. Now, here the quantitative genetics is a branch of population genetics that deals with phenotypes which vary continuously in the character. Okay, again, the quantitative genetics is a branch of population genetics that deals with the phenotype that vary continuously in the characters such as height or the mass of the organism, and it is opposed to discretely identifiable phenotypes and gene products such as the eye color or the presence of a particular biochemical in the body. Okay, deal with. Now, here a polygene or the multiple gene inheritance, is a member of a group of non-epistatic genes. It is a member of a group of non-epistatic genes which is interacting additively to influence a phenotype. Now, what does this non-epistatic gene means? So basically, we do know that the epistatic genes are the genes in which one of the gene is masking the expression of the other gene. And the gene which is masking the expression is called as epistatic gene, whereas the gene which is getting masked is called as hypostatic gene. So here, they are the non-epistatic genes, which means they are not masking or they are not inhibiting each other. Rather, they are additively influencing the other gene. Okay? Deal with. So here, many genes are functioning together for one single function. Okay? The term monozygous is usually referred to, a hypothetical gene, as it is often difficult to characterize the effect of an individual gene. So basically, it is kind of difficult task to characterize the effect of one single gene from the effect of the other genes and the environment on the particular phenotype. So basically, we do have here like the advances in the statistical methodology, or what we call as a statistical analysis, and the high through output, the sequencing rates as well. So statistical analysis is allowing the researchers to locate the candidate gene, or rather what we call it as the gene of interest, candidate gene for the trait. So in that case, if the gene is identified with the help of statistical analysis, it is referred to as a quantitative trait locus. We call it as quantitative trait locus, or in short, we will be calling it as QTL. Okay. Now, these genes are generally pleiotropic as well. Now, what does this pleiotropy means? So, whenever one gene is responsible for many functions, is called as pleiotropy. If one gene is responsible for many functions, for imparting many functions in an individual's life, that gene is called as pleiotropic gene. This is somehow opposite to the multiple genes or the multiple alleles. The genes that contribute to the type 2 diabetes are thought to be called as polygenes. Which means many genes are acting together for one single function. So the polygene and the pleiotropy, both of them will be opposite to each other. Now, in recent years, in July 2016, there are some scientists which have reported they have identified a set of 355 genes. From the last universal common ancestor. Last universal common ancestor of all living organism on earth. Which means, we have 355 genes common with each and every another living organism on the planet Earth. Okay, this is for sure. We have at least 355 genes common with each and every one living organism on the planet Earth. And in case of the human being, we have 99.97% same DNA. 99.9% 99.97% सेम डीएनए, वेयर एज वी हैव ओनली 0.03% डिफरेंट डीएनए देन द अदर ह्यूमंस. गेटिंग? दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई वी आर कॉल्ड एज होमो सैपियन सैपियन. नाउ द ट्रेड विद द पॉलीजेनिक डिटर्मिनिज्म, इट करस्पॉन्ड टू द क्लासिकल क्वांटिटेटिव कैरेक्टर्स विच इज अपोज टू द क्वालिटेटिव कैरेक्टर्स विद मोनोजेनिक और ओलिगोजेनिक डिटर्मिनिज्म. मोनोजेनिक मीन्स सिंगल जीन और ओलिगोजेनिक मीन्स 2 to 10 जीन्स विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर वन सिंगल फंक्शन. सो रिगार्डलेस ऑफ बींग इट एज मोनोजेनिक और द ओलिगोजेनिक, अल्टीमेटली विल बी डीलिंग विद द पॉलीजेनिक डिटर्मिनिज्म. सो हियर इन द एसेंस ऑफ द टू ऑप्शन सच एज द फ्रेकल्स और नॉन फ्रेकल्स, दिस इज जस्ट लाइक द ऑप्शन. Either the freckles like the dots which are present on the face, specifically on the skin, to the freckles or no freckles. But still there are some another cases as well where we have many different variations, just like the color of skin. We do know that there are 7 shades of the human skin color. Okay, we'll be dealing with the human skin color like in detail, but still we have different shades of the human hair color as well. So basically there are 4 shades of the human hair color which are called as black, then we have brown, black, brown, then we have blonde, and at the end of the day we have ginger as well. Ginger, correct? Okay, or rather some people call it as red as well. These are the 4 special hair colors, or even the eye color as well. So there are 5 shades of human eye color. As we all know that the most dominant human eye color is none other than brown, then black, then green, then hazel, one another eye color as well, and the last but not the least one is the blue, the most recessive one. So these are the 5 eye color in the humans. Okay, now dealing with the last but not the least one in detail. Okay, so let's get started. Here you have different types of the phenotypes here. If you will be observing them in close fashion, like there are 7 shades of the human eye color depending on the 3 different genes are present in the genotype of the individual. The colors are the extremely dark, very dark, dark, intermediate, light, very light, and extremely light, or what we call it as albino. I'll be dealing with that there only. So here in this case of the extremely dark human skin shade, we have all the genes in the dominant form. All the 6 alleles are in the dominant form, or the 3 genes are in the homozygous dominant form. But in case of the very dark, if I am dealing here, I am having like one recessive gene, one recessive allele rather I should say, correct? Just check it out here again. Now whenever I am dealing with a dark one, I am dealing with a dark one here I have 2 different alleles here. You can check it out, like the small a and the small b, correct? Hopefully you are able to observe this. Now if I am dealing with the intermediate skin color, we have all of them in the heterozygous form, just like the capital A small a, capital B small b, and the capital C small c. So this is what the intermediate skin color is. And whenever I am dealing with a light skin color, it is having a lot of 4 recessive alleles. Like both the A are in the small form, which is the recessive form, one of the B is in the small form, and one of the C gene is in the small form. C allele is the small form. And now like if I am dealing with a very light one, here I am having 5 recessive alleles, small a, small a, small b, and small c here. And if I am dealing with the last but not the least one, the extremely light, which is having all the alleles in the recessive format, small a, small a, small b, and the small c, small c. So whenever I am dealing with, like, if all the genes are there in the dominant form, the unit of the pigment will be 6 out of 6. And if all the alleles, none of the allele is present, like the unit of the pigment will be 0 out of 6. Just check it out here. Okay, correct. Now what I've told you, that the extremely light color has another name called as albino, or what we call it as albino as well, albino. Okay, so deal with these cases as well, like the absence of the pigment will be albino. Done? Okay, so this was all about the quantitative genetics, or what we call as a quantitative inheritance. Hopefully this lecture has been beneficial for you guys. Thank you. Thank you very much for your so much support. If you do have any kind of doubt as well, you can ask me there in the comment section. Thank you.